And welcome to the first episode of All You Need to Know with Vape Train. These series are going to actually be featuring specific dinos, specific items and weapons, just all sorts of things so that you can find out everything you need to know if you don't feel like going and reading it on the wikis or anything. Also, a few of my personal experiences. But today, the topic is going to be these cute little bastards. Now, Jerboa are great. Little backpacks, like you can actually have them on your shoulder. They only transfer 50% of the item weight. So if you ended up going around and maybe you wanted to get stacks of berries or something, you'd have to level them up in weight. Regrettably, they are set at level 1 on all servers I've seen, except for like unofficial ones where maybe they have changed it up. They're not very good for attacking, as you can see. Yeah, that's like 10 of them versus 1 Jerboa. Like, just one of their kind, and it takes them way too long to kill them. They also are great for monitoring storms. Now, Jerboa are absolutely fantastic for that. They don't actually, besides being a little backpack and a little dino, you just throw at things, and hopefully the carno will eat it before it eats you, you know. Besides that, they're kind of useless. They're just cute as hell. I mean, look at all those little faces.
Look at those faces! They're so damn cute!
Especially little ones on the right. I like those, like with a little bit of orange in the face. They look like little foxes. They're just so cute. But that's really the best thing they're there for. I mean, they poop, they're easy to tame. They're one of the first things you'll end up taming whenever you're actually playing in Scorched. Unless you just hop straight to getting a Merlo Tops. But besides that, these things, they attack, but they don't do enough damage to actually make them worthwhile. Most base stats for Jerboa is like 50 HP. So when that many take that long to kill just one, not good for anything else. They come in many different color varieties. I've seen blacks, I've seen browns, I've seen reds, I've seen oranges, I've seen all sorts of different colors of these things. And you can find these only in the Scorched Earth DLC. At the same time, you can find them just about everywhere. I've seen these things wandering in the dunes. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's just because they like got attacked or something and went running off into the dunes, but yeah, I've seen them just about everywhere. I've even seen them on top of mountains, which is really odd. You would think they wouldn't be there, but they are. They're like the entire vermin of Scorched Earth, but they're entirely far too cute. But yeah, so we're going to go into taming, we're going to go into the different types of storms they monitor. We're also going to go into breeding. Now breeding, I'm not sure if it's really needed, but breeding would mainly be for those who want to have a chance of a mutation happening, like maybe a high stat, or never know, you might get one that's a level 2. I mean, that would be fantastic, wouldn't it? I keep saying, that's never normally the best thing. But, I mean, either way, you know what? I've done so much on this commentary so far, it really doesn't matter. As long as you're getting the information and you get to laugh at me being stupid, that's great. Ooh, look at that one. He's got, like, solid white stripes on his back. So cute. And they're so fast. Run. Get it. Get it. Kill. Kill for your master. Alright, so, we're going to get into the taming, and let's get that started, shall we? So, it's really easy to knock these things out. Either you can run up and you punch them and knock them out, or what I like to do at earlier levels whenever I can make a boomerang, smack them in the head once with a boomerang. They take nine of the actual plant species Y, or you could do 45 mejo, 68 other berries for level 1. And as I said, they all start off at level 1. They normally take, with the species Y, under 5 minutes to tame, and they also take... they're just super easy to tame. Just narco berries and species Y. That's all that matters. Now, the heat waves and stuff like that, this is going into the storms. Heat waves, they sit there and they shake their head and they bury into the ground and like act like they're shaking off the sand. It's because normally whenever a heat wave comes in, it tells you, hey, you need to get underground because, you know, it's about to get really hot. So yeah, they do the whole digging and shaking on your shoulder as well, which is really great. I'm just watching as that ceiling's like knocking into my head as I'm trying to... Yeah, there you go. There's a better view. Okay, so they do that little shimmy. They shake the sand off, basically. But yeah, so that's for the heat storm. Now, upcoming next, I believe, is the sandstorms. Now, before it was the heat wave, now it's sandstorms. And I'm just making sure to show you as many different angles of these as I can. This one actually just happened to have me in it. but this is, it'll sit there and it'll kind of bark and bite towards the air. So you'll see, I'm going to throw it on my shoulder in a minute so you can actually see what it looks like on your shoulder. So as you watch, they sit there and they bite towards the air. Now with the sandstorm will deplete your stamina all the way. You'll slowly, your bags will slowly fill up with sand. It's just overall not something you want to be out in. You also can't really see in it unless you have one of the desert cloth hats. But yeah, sandstorm, one of the best ideas to go inside because you can't really do anything because you have like no stamina whatsoever. So up next is the thunderstorm, I believe. Yeah, thunderstorm's coming up, and it'll be up here in just a moment. And me running around gathering wood for some reason. That's going to get cut out. No, you know, screw it. I mean, the video's only like, what, 17 minutes, something like that? So this is the thunderstorm. See how they quiver their tails and they jabber their jaws? They're all like, that type of thing. Thunderstorms, honestly, don't really affect you except like nighttime visibility whenever it comes down to it. It makes the land get super, super dark. Unless you have electronics or guns, it doesn't affect you, which I'm probably going to have issues with that later. But yeah, they do the whole jabbering their jaws, flailing their tail. Yeah. I'm probably going to just show multiple different images of it, or different videos or scenes of it. This is normally good to make sure that... How in the hell is this section 5 minutes long? What? Okay, the one on my shoulder is really cute because it's all white. Super white, super white. White, white, white. Super white. Should have named it Snowball. Alright, so... The next upcoming one is something absolutely fantastic. Something that you never thought that you'd actually encounter while you're playing on Scorched Earth. You know what that is? It's rain. Mother effin' rain. I didn't expect it to really rain in this... game, this DLC at all. So as soon as I saw the Jerboa doing its little movement, I was ecstatically surprised. Like, I didn't know. So what he does is he will sit there and he'll arch up, and instead of barking or anything, like, he'll just sniff around. Like, he can smell the rain coming. Of course, we all know what rain does. It fills up your water, it fills up your containers. By the way, if you actually use the water reservoirs that you would normally use in the other servers to constantly catch rain to supply your crops, you can actually do the same thing on this server, and it doesn't deplete, as far as I know, which I'll check into that later. But yeah, so it just sits up on your shoulder and it sniffs the air. Now, for breeding. Breeding, as I said, don't know if there's really a purpose to it yet. I don't know if there's a random mutation. We all know the U trick. Get them to follow you, set them on wander, and tap you until they finally either get knocked up or whatnot. Either way, I'm going to speed through this real quick, and I'm pretty sure you don't want to hear the constant whistling, 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 whistling. No one wants to hear that crap. But it doesn't take long. The gestation period, if I remember correctly, is 2 hours and 38 minutes. Now, it turns into the baby phase after that, which... Luckily, since these are mammals, they don't drop eggs, so you actually have to keep the thing alive. You have to keep it fed. But it's all preggers, and it's going to lay it, and it's going to be like one of the cutest things ever. Ready? You're going to watch this, and we're going to watch this thing just plop out. Just come on. Go for it. Go for it. Plop. It's so cute. Oh, my gosh. So this is a little Jerboa baby. Now, of course, it's an herbivore. You need to... get to these things super quick. They have a very low food bar, so they die very quickly. Just hop on them, throw some mejo, some vegetables, whatever you can in there so that it doesn't die. Get out of here. You're in the way. This thing's too cute. All right. But yeah, so baby face. Yeah, little cute little baby. Now, as a baby, it'll be a baby for 2 hours and 5 minutes. I'm pretty sure that if you're just trying to get a chance of getting one that's a higher level, pretty sure you're not going to go through the entire 3 hours and 5 minutes of taking care of this little baby. You'll probably end up just, you know, cycling through them until maybe there's that mutation of getting a really high stat or a higher level, which I still have yet to actually see one come out as a higher level, but I will definitely test it out a little bit more. Now, eventually, God, it's so tiny. Look at it. Look at it. It is so tiny. It's so tiny. It's so cute. Yeah, I spawned this one over on the center map. Not the center map, but the island map. That's why there's water and stuff all close by, and it looks all bright and sunny and not deadly. Alright, so now I'm going to boost through this a little bit. This is actually the juvenile phase. Gets a tiny bit bigger, but that's about it. Shortly, it's going to be the adolescent stage, but in the juvenile phase, it'll stay in this phase for, what is that, 12 hours and 20 minutes? That's a really long time to spend on something if it doesn't give you the mutation. I honestly wouldn't spend my time on it, but you never know. You might love little guys, and you might get lucky and get the perfect stat Jerboa that could take down a T-Rex. No. I don't think you'd ever be able to take one down with the T-Rex. But, so we're going to be coming up on the adolescent stage in just a moment. Definitely see a growth in the size of this baby. It almost doubles in size. It's almost to the point where it's in its adulthood. It's still just absolutely cute. Like, the eyes are so big on these things. Like, look at it. It's so cute, like a little fox. But yeah, it stays in adolescent phase for 15 hours and 25 minutes. And it just will sit there and grow and grow and grow. And make sure to keep feeding it berries. And of course, after the 10% mark, after it gets into juvenile, you just pack a feeding trough full of berries and let it go. But yeah, so that's going to be all finished up shortly. But thank you for coming in and tuning in today, and that is the first All You Need to Know video that I'm going to be putting onto my channel. By all means, like, subscribe, pay attention to the fact that this is one cute-ass little gerbil, basically. And yeah, thanks for watching.